Right, today's video is gonna be a full face of new stuff with the exception of brow products. I don't really like testing new brow products, so anytime people reach out and wanna send me PR, I'm like, nah, I'm pretty good. As I film this on Tuesday, I'm 5 subscribers away from 10K, so if you're subscribed, thank you so much. I appreciate each and every one of you. Now let's get into it.
Woo! 10K! Yeah, you get the strip show now for 10K, you know what I'm talking about? Woo!
He's eating salmon.
Shush. We were here 2 years ago about, and you were at 1,000. And you couldn't even imagine 10,000. Here we are. I love you. You gotta take that whole thing. You gotta take that whole thing.
Oh.
For the team out there, what's up? Congratulations.
I'm winded. Thank you for 10K, everybody. I appreciate you. Before I do the foundation, I'm gonna prep my lips. And so the first new product I have is the Innisfree Lip Sleeping Mask with Canola Honey. This is a product Rudy Berry recommended. She's one of my favorite influencers. She's influenced so many of my purchases. And she's huge on TikTok, also has an awesome YouTube channel, so I will link her in the description box below. But she recommended this because she loves the scent of honey and said that this was just a thick, nourishing lip mask. What I love about it is, unlike the Laneige lip sleeping mask you have to dig your nails into, you kind of have to like scoop out the product with your nail. This is nice and wide, so I can just rub my finger pad over it and apply it on my lips. It's so thick and occlusive. Oh my God. It's a soft honey scent. It almost smells like honey and chamomile or something really comforting. One of my favorite scents I've ever smelled. I'm absolutely hooked on this. Wow. I mean, you just want to like rub it all over your face. It's so good. That's a 10 out of 10 win. Now I will finally show the Fit Glow foundation. This is in the shade C2.5. And let me tell you a little bit about it because they sent me this nice little info card. The Fit Glow formula has amber, which rejuvenates complexion with high antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, helps fight free radical damage, smooths and softens skin texture. And then each ingredient has an explanation from an esthetician, which is super cool. Also has vitamin C, which helps diminish hyperpigmentation and fine lines. Bamboo juice has electrolytes for hydration, minimizes inflammation, soothes redness-prone conditions. Then we've got caffeine, which firms and brightens while reducing puffiness and swelling. Also contains heart leaf, which hydrates and nourishes the skin, prevents the formation of breakouts, soothes irritation and inflammation. Then we have bayberry, which brightens complexion, combats environmental damage, green tea extract, rejuvenates skin, balances sebum production, reduces signs of aging, preserves collagen production. Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Okay, I love Fit Glow's inclusive marketing. I just love it. And I just love their wonderfully balanced shade ranges. So in terms of the actual product description, it says it's a photo filtering foundation that delivers natural antioxidants to care for skin all day while creating a healthy looking flawless finish. The first thing I love about this foundation, Doe Fit Applicator. I talk about this all the time that one of the reasons I prefer to use concealer as foundation is because having a Doe Fit applicator just makes me use less product. And I find it to be a more enjoyable experience that way. I'm also gonna take their foundation brush, which I love. I think it's a great addition. It looks like a really thick handle, but surprisingly, I don't find it too heavy. I don't like when very thick handles are heavy because it hurts my hands after a while. But I like this one. It blends in really well. And I've talked about this foundation before on Instagram and on YouTube, but some people said that they didn't see the video. So Today's the day.
And what's amazing about this is it just looks truly like photo-filtered skin. It sets down to this beautiful satin finish. It blends in like a dream, doesn't highlight texture, doesn't emphasize pores, doesn't have any fragrance or essential oils. It just looks like really beautiful skin. So that's the foundation. I think it looks beautiful. It feels great. It's not drying. It's not super glowy and greasy. The only thing is, over the course of an hour, it does kind of start looking a little bit glowy in my T-zone, the kind of glowiness that most people like. I would prefer if it stayed this kind of satin matte finish, but it's really not a big deal. I'll just like blot my face throughout the day and the foundation doesn't break up, doesn't get weird, lasts all day, super nice. So I guess if there were like one thing I could critique about it, I would probably say if you have oily skin, it might get too glowy for you, but you'll see at the end of this video what it sets to, and that's the finish that it stays at all day. Speaking of new foundations, I tried the new Makeup Forever Ultra HD Skin Foundation on my Instagram. Did a whole wear test and everything. I will leave that wear test linked in the description box below because I'm not going to be filming a review for YouTube. I'm so pissed that Makeup Forever reformulated the Invisible Cover Foundation because this is amazing. This is so similar to the Ultra HD Invisible Cover Foundation, but they made it even thinner. And it's a satin matte finish, which is my favorite. The problem is they added a whole bunch of fragrance. It's not even at the end of the ingredients list. It's like halfway through the ingredients is like parfum, is fragrance. And then they also added a bunch of alcohol in it. So after I tried this the next day, I woke up with rashes all over my forehead and my cheeks. That's the number one indicator for me that I have a compromised barrier, other than like stinging, burning sensations, which I didn't get. But normally fragrance doesn't cause a stinging sensation on me. It's more so it'll cause like a reaction on my face and give me rashes over time. So sadly, I'm never gonna wear this again. It's one of the best foundations I've ever tried, but I will leave my wear test in the description box below. If you are not sensitive to fragrance, then you might love this. So I don't know if you can see from the Makeup Forever skin tint, I should have showed when my skin was bare, but these kind of rashes and breakouts here, 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 I'm hoping you can see some of the rashes coming through because the Fit Glow foundation isn't full coverage, it's like medium. So a little bit is still gonna show through, but my cheek right here took the worst of the Makeup Forever reaction. So I do have some blemishes and redness to cover up today. I'm taking the Fit Glow concealer. I don't have any other new concealers. Fit Glow, always and forever, nothing's better in my opinion. And I think you can see with the Fit Glow foundation, I pretty much don't even need concealer under my eyes. I'm just gonna go like this and that's it. And actually what I like to do when I have a concealer on blemishes, because blemishes are raised, I want the concealer to really stick to that texture. So I actually like to let my concealer sit on my blemishes. That way it kind of starts setting and it becomes less blendable. So it really stays on the blemish. Okay, and now my brows. This is the last product that's not new to me. I just go in with my L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer in Brunette. I just feel like when you find a drugstore product that is absolute fire, I don't need anything else. I don't want to spend money on anything else. That's actually why I'm on this tubing mascara journey right now. I always repurchase the Thrive mascara because it's my favorite, right? Well, with Thrive, you have to pay for shipping, so I end up having to pay $31, you know, every few months for mascara, and I don't know, I just don't like that. So I feel like it's time, the drugstore is going to give me some dupes, and I already have some amazing products. Okay, just going to take a little e.l.f. Wow Brow and Taupe. Why is my mirror over here? I'm such an idiot. You would think by now I would like have a filming setup that makes sense. Nope, I don't. Everything is just completely jerry-rigged. It's super difficult and I make my life harder. Is that an Aquarius thing to do? I feel like it is. I like this brow gel because it's actually like a hair lighter than my brow color. So I find that when I use my darker pencil, the taupe shade of the e.l.f. Wow Brow just kind of softens everything. Brows done. Next new thing is the Wander Beauty On The Glow Blush and Illuminator. I did a try on where I put every single blush shade on my cheek in the same position so you could see the difference between the shades. And I also used their Nude Glow Illuminator in every one. So for today, I'm gonna use Sienna Sunset, which is just a gorgeous kind of burnt orange I thought would be
really pretty with the rest of the look that I'm doing. I normally use it with a brush, but I forgot to grab one, so I'm just gonna use my fingers, which is totally fine with this formula. You can use it however you like. With the On The Glow formula, I find that it's a cross between like a cream, like more like balm stick, because it's kind of sheer, but you guys know that I don't like cheek balms because they're just too sticky and I feel like they lift up foundation. This doesn't do that. It also has a quality of the M Cosmetics soft blur sticks. Like, it's very soft and very, very creamy, but it's a little more sheer and a little more balmy than those. So if the M Cosmetics one were just like a little too intense for you, maybe check these out. Now I'm taking their Nude Glow highlighter, which is just a stunning kind of sheer rosy tan. I think it would work on all skin tones. This is the highlighter shade that's in all of the blushes, so I think it's so sheer it would work on everyone. And it just kind of adds like a little bit of glossiness that's not sticky. I don't like a sticky formula. It just feels like a really nice cream. So I think now you can see what I'm talking about with the Fit Glow foundation. After a few minutes, the oils just kind of like settle into your skin, and now it looks a little bit more glowy. So I am just gonna go in with a powder since I like to control the oil in my T-zone. I'm using Charlotte Tilbury. I was hoping to have the new Say, I think it's called Airsoft, Airset powder. They were supposed to send it to me, but I don't know where it is. I haven't received it yet. For eyeshadow, recently Amanda Z recommended this Dior shadow in the shade Beige Mitzvah. I was sold. It was so easy. I saw that. It was the first product she showed in her video. I paused, I bought it, went back to the video and finished the video. So I will leave her video in the description box because I was hashtag influenced. And I always prefer to just go in with my finger first when it comes to eyeshadows. If it's like satin or metallic, I just prefer the way that that looks on the lid, and then I'll add it in the crease as a one and done, which will be softer and a little less shiny. Ooh. Oh, it's a yes. So what Amanda Z said about this eyeshadow that sold me, not just that the formula was beautiful, but that it looks like the powder version of Charlotte Tilbury Oyster Pearl, and she's spot on. I'm taking my Morphe M433, which is just like this super duper fluffy brush. I don't know if you can see that, but whatever. And I'm just gonna blend that around the crease. Wow, it's the same color as Oyster Pearl. She's right. That's incredible, because so many people feel that the Eyes to Mesmerize formula, while it's beautiful, fades and creases really quickly. And it does, it for sure does. So if you've wanted that, this is an incredible alternative. It's the same color that's kind of, in some lights, a little bit like cool-toned olivey, in other lights more of like a warmer bronze. It's really just a wonderful kind of shape-shifting shade, and that's why I love it as a one and done. Isn't that nice? Then I'm just gonna do the same thing on the other eye. I'm also gonna take a little smudger brush. This is an old one from MAC. I don't even know the name of it anymore, and I'm gonna see what it looks like under the eyes. It may be too light, or it might be just right for a natural little shadow. I prefer using a powder shadow on my lower lash line, just because if I used a cream, I just feel like it would look a little weird with my concealer. I don't want to add a lot of emollient products on my fine lines, you know? It actually looks really nice as a lower lash line shade. And what I do is I blend my lower lash line shade into this, my deepest fine line that starts here and goes all the way down here. I just kind of soften that, and I find that it actually makes it look a little bit smoother than if I just had concealer and no shadow. And on the other eye, I'm just touching up my blemishes because I'm not used to a lot of breakouts. Ugh, fuck that Makeup Forever foundation, I'm so mad. Have you guys been watching any good TV lately? Please give me recommendations below. Just nothing that's like gory or horror. I can't handle that. Like, even Yellowstone is too much for me. I'm a very gentle soul. So we just finished The Great, finally. Loved. We have one episode left of Euphoria. We loved American Crime Story Impeachment. We love Succession. We're making our way through What We Do in the Shadows. Oh, we started The Dropout about Elizabeth Holmes and Theranos. That's fantastic. It's on Hulu. Also started Pam and Tommy. Equally fantastic. So devastating what the world did to Pamela Anderson. Holy shit. So our favorite kind of show is like a mixture of a drama and a comedy, like Succession, like The Great. you know, Pam and Tommy, etc. But I also love my little 30-minute comedies. New Girl's my favorite of all time. I'm also weirdly loving How I Met Your Father. Like, it's just like a quick break from reality. And for some reason, when I'm watching How I Met Your Father, I just feel like I'm a little child who's like in a safe world. I don't know what it is, but both John and I are weirdly enjoying it, and we like don't like sitcoms. I'm taking MAC Costa Riche. This is not a new product. I didn't think I was gonna use any eyeliner, but I just wanted to put some color on the outer lash line. I don't even do a wing. I just kind of add a little bit there. And really all it does is it ends up making my lashes look a little bit lifted and a little bit deeper at the root. See how the MAC Costa Riche just kind of deepened everything a little bit? It's a warm brown, but it kind of just looks like I made it a little bit more smoky. Lashes are curled, now I'm gonna go back in with MAC Costa Riche, and I'm only gonna do the upper waterline from here out. From here out, because if I put it in the inner corner like this, it ends up smudging down my eye, so I cannot recommend this eyeliner for waterline. But it's the only eyeliner I have right now because I like to keep my collection minimal, so oh well. Let's talk new mascaras. So in my recent fails and declutter video, I talked about the Merit mascara not working out for me. It's a tubing mascara and it just had such a natural finish. It was like, it didn't hold a curl, didn't make my lashes look particularly volumized or lengthened. So I sent that one back to Sephora. I had so many people DM me that I had to try these two. The Maybelline Sky High, which I didn't know was a tubing mascara. People really recommended this. Also, another Rudy Berry recommendation, which was confirmed by several people in my DMs, the L'Oreal Age Perfect Lash Magnifying Mascara, only the waterproof version. Note, the waterproof version is tubing, which is so weird. It's called washable waterproof. Huh? I wish they would just call mascaras tubing mascaras. Like, you have to go deep into the literature of the product to find where it says tubular formula. But I digress. I tried this the other day, the same try-on with the Make Up Forever foundation, and this is incredible. It's a much drier formula than Thrive, and it's a natural bristle, so it doesn't have that like plasticky spiky wand. Some people told me they thought this was too dry and didn't build enough, and I understand what they're saying, but I prefer a drier formula. It definitely was kind of dry, that it focused all the product on the root of my lashes, but I thought that it made me look like I was actually wearing eyeliner because it was just like so black at the root. It held a curl very well, never flaked or smudged. It was more on the volumizing side, not so much lengthening. Like, the Thrive will like double the length of your lashes. Sometimes I prefer that look, so I always have a Thrive mascara on hand. I'm so glad now that I have a drugstore mascara I can recommend, because I was also just sick of buying Thrive, which is $31 when you pay shipping. So this is incredible. L'Oreal Age Perfect, waterproof. I'm not gonna show this today because I have so many others to test right now. I'm gonna link this in the description box below where I did my try on, and you can see exactly how it looked as I applied it. No flaking, no smudging, 10 out of 10. Rudy Berry for the win, right? So I have one from Sephora. This is the one I'm gonna try today because this one had a lot of mixed reviews, and I'm always here to, you know, do a deep dive on a product. I also haven't really heard that many people talk about this. This is the Velour Pretty Big Deal Peptide and Tubing Mascara 3-in-1 Lash Serum, Shield, and Mascara. I like the packaging. It's square. Oh, uh-oh. That can't be good. That can't be good. Yeah. I don't know what's up with that. All right, there's like a bit of a curved brush. I'm nervous. Mascaras are tough. Especially tubing mascaras, they're always like so natural looking, which is why I've only ever liked Thrash. Thrash. That was Thrive and Lash in my mind. Okay, so far so good. Little bit on the natural looking side for me. It's gotta give me drama. It's not bad, it's a nice natural lash. It's like a slightly better version of Cali Ray in my opinion. God, my right eye is such a pain in the dick. It's like,
I can never get these eyelashes on the corner of the right one because they just point down and it looks weird. Does anyone else hate the lashes on one of their eyes? I'm gonna say this is okay. Better than Cali Ray, better than Merit. It does give me a little bit more volume, I would say, than those. It does not hold a curl as well as Thrive and as well as the L'Oreal. So I'm gonna keep testing this and I'll report back. Three new lip products, then we're done. We've got the In Beauty Cookie Lip Glaze, which is a favorite of mine. I've been testing it over the past few weeks. You can still get this on the In Beauty website, even though it's sold out. You can get it in their My Usual Treat bundle that comes with this like fuzzy pink makeup bag and the usual candle from the new Savant, which is Ingrid Nilsson's brand. And it smells like pistachio, black coffee, cocoa, grounded with some notes of like cedarwood and patchouli. It basically smells like fresh brownies are baking in the oven and you just poured your first cup of hot coffee of the day. Like it is a 10 out of 10 candle to me because it's gourmand without being sickeningly sweet. It's just very, very comforting. And so you can get this in that bundle. I'm gonna do the Fit Glow first. The one I'm least excited about is Dahlia. It's like a pink purple. Not a huge fan of like opaque purples. Yeah, not for me. I appreciate Fit Glow for sending this to me, but it's just sadly not my shade. Now we have the shade Carotene, which is like, I think supposed to be like a creamy tangerine. That's nice. Yeah, like more of an amped up version of Koi. It's darker. I thought this one would go nicely with that Sunset Blush from Wander Beauty, which I just applied very sheerly. But I think I would actually prefer Cookie today. So In Beauty Cookie is light warm beige that smells like Biscoff cookies. And I just wanted like a nude right now, you know? It's not too creamy or too milky. I was worried it was gonna be like leave that white ring on the lips or look like it would wash me out. It's not. So I guess if you're new here, you've never heard me talk about these. I have so much content about the Fit Glow lip serums. I work with them all the time. The lip serums are my favorite product ever. I own, I don't know, 35 of them. If I could only have one lip product for the rest of my life, it would be the Fit Glow lip serums. So I will leave in the description box below a video where I swatched every single shade on my lips and compared them on my arms. I also have a ton of content on the In Beauty lip glazes. Super cushiony formula, more like a cross between an oil and a lip gloss, but cushiony, nourishing, fun flavors, fun like fuzzy, chubby applicator. And the Fit Glow lip serums are like a cushiony, gel-like formula that really transforms and treats the lips with a ton of skincare ingredients, but also with mineral pigments as well. And there's a shade and a texture for everyone. Totally forgot, for In Beauty, you can use my code KAIT15 now. That's KAIT15 for 15% off. For Fit Glow, you can use my code KAIT20 for 20% off. That's KAIT20. So hopefully that helps. Final thoughts. Okay, Fit Glow foundation. I think it looks beautiful. I think it made my skin look just like skin, but more perfected. I agree with the sort of like photo-ready marketing. I like that. I wish it weren't quite so glowy in my T-zone, but at least it doesn't look greasy. It's not even really glowy. It's just more so that it lets my sort of natural oils come through right here, here, and here. And I do prefer a more satin matte finish, like the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Skin that broke me out and I now can't use. But honestly, all I have to do is powder and I'm fine with the Fit Glow. So just keep that in mind if you have oily skin, if you have dry skin, I'm sure this would be a total win. I love the Wander Beauty Blush and Illuminator because I can use my fingers. The shades are beautiful. I like that it's kind of a more sheer application. You can definitely build it up. I mean, especially the shade Strawberry Fields, like you can get full pigment. I particularly love the highlight shade. I think it just looks like a great match and I love the texture of it. I love that it's creamy, not sticky. My hair doesn't like stick to my face. Eyeshadow that Amanda Z recommended. Wow, the Dior Beige Mitzvah looks like the powder version of Oyster Pearl. Absolute love. The Fit Glow lip serums I think are too pigmented for my personal taste. Those shades are great for other people, but you know me. I like a sheer, barely there lip, so love the formula, but those particular colors aren't for me. Love the Cookie Lip Glaze, one of my favorites that they've put out. The Velour Mascara, honestly, I could see myself returning because it just doesn't give me enough of anything, and if it smudges or flakes or is difficult to remove, I will definitely return it.
It seems to be holding a curl pretty well on this side though. I think I just had some issues applying it while trying to like talk and also balance a mirror. So I'm gonna keep testing it before I give it a negative review. Next time you'll see me do the Maybelline. And lastly, probably my favorite out of all of this. I don't know, the foundation, the eyeshadow, and this Honey Innisfree lip mask is just, I don't wanna live without this. I love this so much. It's so thick. The smell and the fact that it comes in this wide pot so I don't have to get my nails in there. Amazing. That's it if you made it this far. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you'll subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.